د افغانستان د ټاکنیز بهیر لامله د رامنځته شوي جنجال حل لارې د موندنې په اړه غواړو د همدې بهیر د یو نړیوال متخصص نظر واخلو. سټافن دارنوف د انتخاباتي سیستم په نړیوال بنسټ کې د نوښتونو او پروګرامونو د پراختیا د څانګې مشر دی. د یو متخصص او علمي قدر په توګه یې په انتخاباتي پروسه او ډیموکراتیک چاپیریال رامنځته کولو کې کار کړی دی او د جګړو ځپلو ټولنو او د ډیموکراسۍ پر لور روانو ټولنو کې د ټاکنیزو اصلاحاتو په برخه کې ځانګړې تجربه لري. ښاغلی دارنوف په دې اړه نه هم کړی دی او نن موږ د افغانستان د ټاکنیز بهیر په اړه د خبرو لپاره دلته د واشنگتن په استودیو کې ورته بلنه ورکړی ده. دا نو تاسو ستړي مشي یو پوښتنه مې دا کوله چې تاسو
کې
Well, you can definitely tell that the audit is dominating politically in Kabul and Afghanistan. You can also see the audit is in full swing. As of yesterday, we had about one-third of the polling stations have been audited. The presidential candidates are very engaged, and so is the civil society, as well as the international media.
You also worked in Afghanistan during the 2005 parliamentary elections. How does the current election compare?
Well, if we're looking at the IEC, the institution that's responsible for organizing the elections, I think in spite of the problems we're now seeing, it has become much more professional. It's logistically much more strong. It has a much better relationship with the security forces, which is essential for organizing elections in Afghanistan. But we also have still a problem that remains from the time when I was a commissioner in 2005, and that is how do we ensure that the ad hoc workers on election day, 100,000 people, that they are not just informed on what they're supposed to be doing, but they're politically neutral. And I think that's the main challenge we've been facing up until today.
As you know, the vote annulment process is set to begin. What signs do you watch for to ensure that such a process is handled fairly?
I think there are basically three things we look for. Do we have regulations that are well known to the all the stakeholders in the game? Do we adhere? Do we implement these regulations uniformly? Because we do have an audit taking place amongst more than 100 teams in three different warehouses. We need to make sure that these rules are applied uniformly. And then thirdly, that the stakeholders, the parties, the observers, and the media have full access to the process. Only then can we have a credible audit taking place.
Can you walk us through the audit process? لکه که واضح که چه پخپلا پا مجموع که داده تفتیش ده بیازالیش میرنه و تفتیش ده پروسه چه دول ده اصلا؟
As I said, we have three warehouses with 100 teams open up these boxes. Each team have an IEC representative, representatives from the presidential candidates and observers. Once they've looked through the box using the green checklist, they will deposit the checklist with the data center where they're entering the results from these things, because we need to be able to process these forms so we can give them to the Board of Commissioners so they can actually make a ruling. Do we invalidate the ballot box? Do we invalidate some of the ballots in the ballot box? Or will their results remain the same as from the original results we received? So that's the process they're going through right now. A lot of focus has been on the actual audit, but it's equally important that this database and that we can present the papers in a timely manner to the Board of Commissioners so they can make a ruling. And once they make a ruling, and they will start releasing these in the coming days, then we might have some political tension again, because only then will we know who will be the winner and the loser from these ballot boxes.
What lessons
can Afghanistan learn from this year's vote that can be applied to future elections?
I think it is to plan for a rainy day. We cannot just assume that everything will go in accordance to plans. We need to have a contingency plan. And given the history we have when it comes to malpractices and fraud in Afghanistan, we should probably have had a plan B when it comes to something going slightly wrong. Of course, it's almost impossible to plan for every contingency, and this is a unique situation. So, but better planning, we could have been slightly better prepared in moving forward with something like this.
خاغله صف اندانو کور دی ودان چې مونږ بلنه منلې
و. Thank you. Pleasure being here.
مننه تاسو نه هم.